Imagine you are able to read the thoughts in people's mind when you come in contact with them. What would be your reactions? What about if they're able to read your thoughts? What evil will they discover about you? Our lives are shaped by the thoughts we keep inside our heads. According to the National Science Foundation, an average person has about 12,000 to 60,000 thoughts per day. Of those, 80% are negative and 90% are repetitive thoughts. People are always quick to tell you to keep your mind positive, as if most people want to keep a negative thought. At times, a person does not know how to fight it, and most of us are not trained on how to maintain an optimistic view of things. Furthermore, there is a violent battle for our minds raging around us 24 hours a day. We are bombarded with ads on television and radio. As we walk or drive down the road, we encounter several billboards trying to shape our thoughts. There is lust and perversion everywhere you look, all in the hope of defiling God's temple. The devil knows if he can keep our minds occupied with fear, with worry and anxiety, with lust, it will consume us to stop us from thinking about God. 2 Corinthians 10 verse 3-5 tells us, "Though we walk in the flesh, we are not waging war according to the flesh." In other words, we do not fight with armor. We do not fight with politics, fight with money. We do not fight with all the humanistic ways. For the weapons of our warfare are not of flesh, but have divine power to destroy strongholds. We destroy arguments and every lofty opinion raised against the knowledge of God, and take every thought captive to obey Christ. Satan's desire is to conquer and control your thought life, and then make it a stronghold from which he can war against God. The good news is, when God saved you, he gave you the mind of Christ. The problem we face, we live in the flesh. We have to admit it. We are weak. All of us have problems, sickness, confusions, and we suffer through the everyday things of life. The battle we face as believers is against the devil himself, and by ourselves we cannot fight him. People of the world think if we just keep a positive mind, all our lives will be better. There are demons that hounds our mind and continue battle for control of our soul and spirit. I agree, we should maintain a more optimistic mindset, but we need to remember that Adam and Eve fell into sins when they were deceived by the devil. They had a better environment than we do today, and the devil was able to mess with their minds. Today's believers of Christ lives in a polluted environment, and as we go through challenges of life, at times we do not see a way out. The mind tends to want to take us to a dark hole. 1 Peter 1 verse 13 tells us, "Called to be holy therefore, preparing your minds for action, and being sober-minded, set your hope fully on the grace that will be brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christ." As believers of Jesus Christ, how do we stay sober-minded? The Bible tells us in Colossians 3 verse 2, "For us to set our mind on things that are above, not on things that are under earth." This verse also poses another question for me. How do we keep our minds on things above, not on the earth, when it seems these thoughts are randomly appearing with us, not having any control, especially when these are negative and evil thoughts? The Bible tells us to be careful what we allow to come out of our mouths. Matthew 15 verse 18 through 19 tells us, "But those things which proceed out of the mouth come from the heart, and they defile a man. For out of the heart proceed evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornications, thefts, false witness, and blasphemy." We are not going to win the battle of the mind with carnal weapons. Instead, we are going to win because of the sovereignty of our God Jehovah. The devil has been trying to do all he can to win this war, but Jesus died at Calvary. He defeated the devil. Jesus said in John 12 verse 31, "Now is the judgment of this world. Now shall the prince of this world be cast out." As born-again Christians, we are going to overcome the battle of the mind because God has given us authority. In Luke 10 verse 19 to 20, the Bible tells us, "Behold, I give you the authority to trample on serpents and scorpions and all over the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Nevertheless, do not rejoice in this, that the spirit are subject to you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven." Lastly, we can win this battle because we belong to Jesus Christ. 2 Corinthians 2:14, the Bible tells us, "Now thanks be to God who always led us in triumph in Christ, and through us diffuses the fragrance of his knowledge in every place. Not only should you fight the battle and defeat the devil, but also you need to fill your mind with godly thoughts. Philippians 4 verse 8 through 9 tells us, "Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are good report, if there be any virtue, if there be any praise, think of these things." Every spiritual battle begins in the mind. Our mind is a powerful tool and can either be our greatest ally in spiritual warfare or can be our greatest foe. We can literally defeat ourselves in our mind. The enemy knows this and he will use it to his advantage every time. Center your mind upon Jesus Christ and do not let the devil take away your pure-hearted devotion to him. Ephesians 4 verse 23 tells us, "Be renewed in the spirit of your mind." And in Ephesians 6 verse 17, the Bible says, "Take the helmet of salvation and the word of the Spirit, which is the word of God." Let us pray. Heavenly Father, I come before you today to say thank you for everything you've done for my life. Forgive me the ability to pull down the stronghold of confusion in my life in the name of Jesus. For every seat of confusion in my life be broken down in the name of Jesus. Father, let the storm of confusion within my mind be still in the name of Jesus. Every cloud of confusion that has enveloped my mind, I command you to fade away now in the name of Jesus. I reject every storm of confusions and claim a sound mind in the name of Jesus. Every power that wants to destroy my life, I command you to be destroyed today in Jesus' name. Every faulty foundation in my life, receive the fire of God in the name of Jesus. I fire back every arrow of mind destruction, fire into my life back to sender in Jesus' name. My mind receive divine touch and be relieved in the name of Jesus. Lord, strengthen me in my inner mind with your fire and your power in Jesus' name. I pull down every stronghold of controllable thoughts in my life in the name of Jesus. I cast down every evil imagination in my heart in the name of Jesus. I bring into captivity every area of my thoughts into the obedience of Christ in the name of Jesus. I break the power of evil remote control over my thought in the name of Jesus. I seal off every doorway of evil controllable thought in my life with the blood of Jesus Christ. I scatter into pieces every evil imagination against me in the name of Jesus. I command all imagination contrary to my prayer life to be defeated in the mighty name of Jesus. I cast down and bring to naught every demonic imagination against me and my family in Jesus' name. I immune my spirit, my soul, and body against every vain imagination in the name of Jesus. I cast out, I plunder, and frustrate every satanic imagination against my life in the name of Jesus. Lord, I pull down every stronghold of the enemy over my life in the name of Jesus. I pull down and roast every demonic ladder the enemy is using to climb into my life in the name of Jesus. I come against every evil pronouncement made against my life in the mighty name of Jesus. I arrest and bind every satanic notebook written against my life in the mighty name of Jesus. I cancel and nullify every imagination of the enemy upon my life in the mighty name of Jesus. I take captive every evil thought in my heart in the name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, cleanse my heart from every evil thought in the name of Jesus. My heart be delivered from every evil thought in the name of Jesus. I shield my heart with the fire of God from every evil thought in the name of Jesus. Heavenly thoughts fill my heart in the name of Jesus. You my mind in the name of Jesus. You will not push me to hell in Jesus' name. You habitation of darkness in my heart, be desolate in the name of Jesus. Every evil attack on my mind be defeated in the name of Jesus. You my mind receive the touch of fire of God in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I will make it in life. I command satanic table upon which he exhibits evil in my heart to receive the fire of God in Jesus' name. Stings of death, release my mind in the name of Jesus. Sting of fear and failure, release my mind in the name of Jesus. I command every heavy burden in my mind to roll away and be burned to ashes in Jesus' name. Blood of Jesus, replenish my heart in Jesus' name. You powers that corrupt my desire in my mind, be roasted in the name of Jesus. You strong men of evil imagination, paralyze the good things in my life. Be paralyzed in the name of Jesus. Lord, preserve my mind with your fire in the name of Jesus. Lord, put your laws into my mind in the name of Jesus. All the good thoughts that the strong man has paralyzed in my life, receive life and be restored back into my life in Jesus' name. I locate every evil tree in my life with the fire of God in the name of Jesus. I uproot every hidden evil tree in my mind in the name of Jesus. You evil fruit in my mind, die today in Jesus' mighty name. You plenty of evil tree in my life, be roasted in the name of Jesus. Lord, begin to plant good things in my life and let the good fruits begin to manifest in Jesus' name. I bind and cast down the spirit of uncertainty in my mind and I render its activity null and void in my life in Jesus' name. Holy Ghost, occupy every area vacated by spirit of uncertainty in my mind in the name of Jesus. Lord, every damaged spirit of uncertainty has done in my life be repaired today and restored in Jesus' name. I refuse to give space to spirit of uncertainty in my life in Jesus' name. I recover and possess every good thing lost to the spirit of uncertainty in the name of Jesus. Throughout the days of my life, the gate of hell shall not prevail over my life in Jesus' name. You power of hell, release all my belongings that are under your control in the name of Jesus. As for me and my house, our names will not enter the kingdom of hell in the name of Jesus. You spirit of death, you will not prosper in my life in the name of Jesus. I release the life of Christ into my life in Jesus' mighty name. My mind, I command you to think clear in the name of Jesus. All my control spirit be bound in the name of Jesus. You producer of evil thoughts in my life, somersault and die in Jesus' mighty name. Holy Spirit, renew my mind to glorify God's name in Jesus' name. Lord, soak my mind with heavenly revelations. I gather together every area of my mind that have been scattered in the name of Jesus. Every area of my life and area of my mind in satanic cage be released tonight in the name of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus into my mind and into the whole of my life. I fire back every arrow of the enemy fired into my life in the name of Jesus. I command you, my mind, go back to your resting place in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, help me to locate any spiritual disease in my mind. I release myself from the grip of this spirit of pride, of carnal imagination, of vanity and deception, greed and fear, wicked imagination, ignorance, violence and bitterness, any arrogance or mind blankness, any envy or forgetfulness, any laziness or depression, mind darkness, confusion and mind dullness, any turmoil of self-importance and condemnation. Father, in the name of Jesus, I invite the ministry of deliverance into my mind. I locate every evil tree in my mind with the fire of God in the name of Jesus. You power of darkness, lose your control over my mind in the name of Jesus. Let my carnal mind, which is at war with God, be conquered and be at peace with God in the name of Jesus. I cast down every vain imagination working against my mind in the name of Jesus. Let every wild, untamed, and restless thoughts be captured and brought into submission under the feet of Christ in Jesus' name. I pray this prayer tonight in Jesus' mighty name. To God be all the glory. Amen.